Bundle branch blocks. A bundle branch block is suspected when the width of the QRS complex is more than 3 small squares, that is more than 0.12 seconds. This is because when one bundle branch is blocked, only one ventricle will be activated first, and then the impulse will pass to the other ventricle across the septum, resulting in delayed depolarization in abnormal direction. In this diagram, the left bundle branch is interrupted at 4. So the right ventricle gets depolarized in the normal sequence at 4 and 5. And then the impulse passes across the septum to the left ventricle at 6. The width of the QRS complex or the QRS interval is counted from the beginning of the Q or R wave, whichever is first, to the end of the QRS complex. And whenever the QRS complex in any of the leads is wider than 3 small squares, a bundle branch block is diagnosed. Now let us learn to differentiate between right and left bundle branch blocks. When the QRS complexes are noted to be wide, first look for a positive, wide and slurred M-shaped pattern, that is RSR' or RR' pattern in the chest leads. If it is seen over the right chest leads, that is in V1 or V2, it is a right bundle branch block. And if it is seen over the left chest leads, that is V5 or V6, it is a left bundle branch block. At the same time, the opposite chest leads will display a wide and slurred S wave. So the features of right bundle branch block are wide QRS complexes 3 mm or more wide, an RSR' pattern also called as M pattern or rabbit ears in lead V1, and broad slurred S wave in leads V5 and V6. It may also be associated with right axis deviation. To revise, right bundle branch block shows wide QRS complexes 3 mm or more wide, RSR' pattern in V1, broad S wave in V6, and right axis deviation may be present. In this ECG, measure the width of the QRS complex in lead V1. It is 3 small squares. Now note the RSR' pattern in V1 and V2. Note that the T wave is opposite to the direction of the wide terminal QRS deflection. In V5 and V6, a wide S wave is seen. So the diagnosis is right bundle branch block. Note again the rabbit ears in V1 and wide S wave in V6. This is another ECG of right bundle branch block. Note the RSR' pattern in V1. Typical rabbit ears in V2 and shallow but wide S wave in V5 and V6, that is right bundle branch block. Note in close-up view RSR' in V1 and wide S wave in V6. Left bundle branch block. The features of left bundle branch block are: number 1, the width of the QRS complexes is 3 mm or more. Number 2, very deep and broad S wave in lead V1 with no R wave. Number 3, broad slurred R wave or RR' pattern without a Q wave in leads V5 and V6. And number 4, left bundle branch block is always associated with left axis deviation. To revise, left bundle branch block shows wide QRS complexes more than 3 mm wide, deep and broad S wave in V1, broad R wave or RR' wave in V6, and left axis deviation. This ECG shows wide QRS complexes. The lead V1 shows broad and deep S wave without an initial R wave. The leads V5 and V6 show broad and slurred R waves. So this is left bundle branch block. Note in close-up view, the broad and deep S wave in V1 and broad and slurred R wave in V6. In particular, note the absence of Q wave in V6 and note that the T waves are opposite in direction to the QRS complexes. Now let us see the limb leads. There is left axis deviation or left leaves pattern. And the changes of left-sided leads V5 and V6 are also seen in 1 and AVL, which are basically left-sided leads. This is another ECG of left bundle branch block. See the broad and deep S wave in V1. The inset shows RR dash pattern in V5. This is broad slurred R wave in V6 and also note the inverted T wave. Left anterior hemi block. The left bundle branch has two fascicles, anterior and posterior. Sometimes only the anterior fascicle of the left bundle branch is affected, causing pure left axis deviation. This is called as left anterior hemi block. It is suspected when there is left axis deviation with no other causative factor, with QR pattern in lead 1 and RS pattern in lead 3. The QRS is slightly widened but not to 3 small squares. Sometimes right bundle branch block may be associated with left anterior hemi block because both bundles have common blood supply. This ECG shows RS R dash pattern in V1 and broad shallow S wave in V5 and V6. So this is right bundle branch block, but in limb leads there is left axis deviation. So this is a right bundle branch block with left axis deviation, or right bundle branch block with left anterior hemi block.